this problem, we're going to practice finding the volume of a solid by slicing. So here's the directions. Find the volume of the solid whose base is the region bounded by y equals x squared and y equals 1 minus x squared, and whose cross sections perpendicular to the x-axis are semicircles. Okay, well, let's start by sketching the base of the region. So the region bounded by y equals x squared and y equals 1 minus x squared. Well, we know y equals x squared is just an upward-facing parabola that goes to the origin. So without drawing a lot of detail in, just something like this. And then we know that 1 minus x squared should be a downward-facing parabola with its vertex here at y equals 1. So roughly something like this. Okay, so we can see now the base of the region of interest here, the area bounded by these curves. Okay, so what's going on here? Well, this is the base of our region. But what actually forms this three-dimensional solid are these semicircular cross-sections that are going to be sitting on top of this base. So we're told that we have cross-sections perpendicular to the x-axis. So that's telling us that our cross-sections are going to be going in this direction. And those cross-sections are semicircles. So if you can picture a semicircle with its base along the green line I just drew, rising out of the page on top of the space. So let me show you really quickly a better sense of what that looks like. So here's our base, right? What we saw on our graph that we drew, and then you can see I have my cross sections here, and they're perpendicular to the direction of the x-axis. Now if I just kind of rotate my figure here, I can show you a little bit what this looks like. So we've got these semicircles, right, that are on top of this base, creating a three-dimensional shape that looks like this. So this is what we're trying to find the volume of. So how are we going to approach this problem? Well, in general, the way we find the volume of a solid by slicing is by integrating. And specifically, what we integrate is the area of the cross sections over some interval, a to b. Okay, so in my case, a and b are going to be these intersection points that bound my region of interest, and we'll find those in a few minutes. So I'm going to integrate a of x dx from a to b, and a of x represents the area of a cross section, and that's going to be in terms of x in our case. Okay, so then what we need to do is we need to actually find the area of one of those cross sections. So my cross sections are semicircular. So I know that in general that the area of a semicircle is pi r squared divided by 2. So 1 half pi r squared, just half the area of a regular circle. So what I need to do then is I need to determine what r is. What is the radius of one of these semicircles in terms of these equations I'm given? Okay, so remember, this upward facing parabola is y equals x squared. My downward facing parabola is y equals 1 minus x squared. So remember that this green line, right, this green line in my graph here represents the diameter of the semicircle, right? If you picture the semicircle rising out of the page, this green line would be the diameter. So let's try to come up with an expression from that, and from there we can find the radius easily. So the diameter is just going to be the height of this line, and at any point that's just going to be the top curve minus the bottom curve. So the diameter then is just going to be 1 minus x squared minus x squared. Well, or 1 minus 2x squared. So that's the diameter of my semicircle, and it's in terms of x, right? And the reason it is in terms of x here is because my cross sections are perpendicular to the x-axis. Later we'll look at an example where the cross sections are perpendicular to the y-axis, and in those cases we'll be integrating with respect to y. But here we're integrating with respect to x. So my diameter is 1 minus 2x squared, then my radius will simply be half of that. So 1 half times the quantity, 1 minus 2x squared. So now I can finish writing my expression for the area using the radius I just found. So area of a semicircle is 1 half pi r squared, and my r is this 1 half times 1 minus 2x squared. And I'm squaring that entire quantity. So let's clean that up just a tad. So that's going to be 1 half times pi times 1 fourth times the quantity 1 minus 2x squared squared. Or I can write that as pi over 8 times 1 minus 2x squared quantity squared. So what we just found then is we just found this expression a of x that we're going to integrate. But what we have left to find is a and b, which are the bounds of our integral. And those bounds come from the bounds of our base, basically. If I'm looking at my picture, I've shown you here a and b. So here a and b are the intersection points of my two curves. So I need to actually take a minute and calculate those intersection points before I can continue with this problem. So then to calculate those points, I'm simply going to take my two curves and set them equal to each other. So I get 1 equals 2x squared, or 1 half equals x squared. So I get x equals plus or minus the square root of 1 half. And here I only need those x values. I don't really care about the y values in my case. And I could also, if you like, write this as plus or minus 1 over root 2. That would be equivalent. So now I'm actually ready to set up my integral. I have all the information I need. So the volume of this solid is going to be given by the integral from negative 1 over root 2 to positive 1 over root 2 of this pi over 8 times a quantity 1 minus 2x squared, quantity squared. I could also pull that pi over 8 out front and write my expression like this. So evaluating this integral will give me the volume of the solid. Now the new thing here is just setting up this integral. So that's the main thing I wanted to address in this video. So in the next a little bit of the video, I'm going to very quickly evaluate this. Just so you have the answer. But once again, the main part here, the new part, is just setting up this integral. And one thing, I should have a dx in here as well. Okay, so if you needed to evaluate this, how would you go about doing that? Well, the first thing you would need to do is actually expand that inside by foiling. Okay, so if you do that, you should get the following. And from here, I simply find the antiderivative of this expression, and that should get me this. And the next, I'm going to plug in my 1 over root 2, subtract, and then plug in my negative 1 over root 2. If you do that, it should look like the following. And, of course, I still have my pi over 8 out front. And then I just have to simplify all these nasty numbers. So if you work through that correctly, you should get this. So it looks like we get pi over 8 times 16 over 15 root 2, which we could also write as, so we get 2 pi over 15 root 2. And that is the volume of the solid. But once again, those computations are kind of nasty, so don't get too caught up in that. The important part here is being able to set up this integral correctly.